It is indeed a pleasure to be here with you again this morning to bring devotion. I thank God for another day and for this privilege. Let us pray. Father God, we praise you this morning. We worship your name. We honor you. We adore you because you are God, just for who you are, God. Father, we praise you. We glorify your name. We thank you, Lord God, for being with us, for waking us up to see another day. We do not know what today holds, God, but we know that you hold it in the palm of your hand. So we place our lives in your hand, God, because we know that we are more than conquerors. We are overcomers through Christ Jesus. Bless this this devotion this morning, Father, and let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Use me, Lord God, to bring a word to somebody this morning, a word in season, God, a word that somebody needs. In Jesus' mighty name we pray, amen. The title of my devotion this morning is God Chose You, Don't Run. God chose you, don't run. I'm reading from Jonah chapter 1, verses 1 to 3, the New King James Version. Now the word of the Lord came to Jonah, the son of Amittai, saying, arise, go to Nineveh, that great city, and cry out against it, for their wickedness has come up before me. But Jonah arose to flee to Tarshish from the presence of the Lord. He went down to Joppa and found a ship going to Tarshish. So he paid the fare and went down into it to go with them to Tarshish from the presence of the Lord. Don't run. God chose you. He chose you. God sent Jonah on a mission, but Jonah made his own choice. God may send us on a mission, but we have to choose to be obedient. Jonah heard God, but he made his own decision. Sometimes we make decisions contrary to God's will, and when we face the consequences, we may blame God or ask why. I believe God knew that Jonah would run, but he chose him anyway. God chose you. Don't run. He could have chosen anybody else, but he chose you. Hallelujah. In spite of whatever he knows you might choose to do, he chose you. And so he will equip you. He has confidence in you. Don't run. Jonah made a choice. He chose to run from God's assignment. The scripture says that he hid from the presence of the Lord. He went down into the bottom of the ship to hide from the presence of God. He chose to run from God's assignment. Verse 3 says he arose to flee from the presence of God, not just to run, but to flee. He was in a state, as we would say, to get out of God's presence because he heard God and he knew what God was sending him to do. But he arose to flee from the presence of God. When we flee from God's presence, when we run from God's presence, our decisions will not be aligned with his will or his plans. The decisions that we make will be our own. They will not be aligned with God's will or God's plans for us when we flee from his presence. Jonah looked for a ship. He looked because the scripture says he found one. He found one going to Tarshish, not to Nineveh, to Tarshish. He paid the fare for the ship. Jonah was walking in rebellion, running from God and his assignment. What is your assignment this morning? All of us know what God has assigned us to do. If you don't know, ask him, and he will surely tell you. He knows what his will is for your life. He knows what assignment he has given you. And some of us know what our assignment is, but we are running from our assignment. What is your assignment this morning? Are you running from it? Are you waiting before you do what God says to do? Delayed disobedience is still delayed obedience is still disobedience. If God says go now, he means go now. We know that Jonah was in the bottom of the ship. That's what the scripture says. He was comfortable in his sin. He was so comfortable in his sin that he went to sleep. But the storm was raging and other people on the ship were afraid. There were other people on the ship. The storm was raging because of Jonah, and they were afraid. Sometimes the choices we make can cause situations that put innocent people in danger. When other people may be fighting for their lives because we make a wrong decision. When we make decisions without God, we will reap the consequences of our actions. Let me repeat that. When we make decisions without God, or apart from what God has said to do, we will reap the consequences of our actions. And other people around us may be affected by the wrong decisions that we have made, because we have made decisions that are out of the will of God. One wrong decision can affect your whole family. One wrong decision can affect the body of Christ. One wrong decision can hinder your spiritual growth. One wrong decision that I may make can hinder my spiritual growth. So we have to make decisions based on what God is telling us to do. God chose you for that assignment. My assignment may not be your assignment, but God chose you. So don't run. The storm came because of Jonah, but those on the ship were also in the storm. Those on the ship were also in the storm. While they were struggling, Jonah was sleeping. He was comfortable. Some people have become so comfortable in disobeying God that they don't even see that the things around are changing. The circumstances are changing. People are being affected by your decision. People are dying and going to hell. Because you refuse to carry the word that God has given you to carry, because you are afraid, because you are timid, because you are afraid of what people will say. God has called you to carry a word to somebody. But because you are timid, because you are afraid, just as Jonah, you are afraid. So you run from your calling. You run from your assignment. I don't know who that was for this morning. Some people can be comfortable in their rebellion, thinking God doesn't see them. But Psalm 139 and 7 says, where can I flee from your spirit? Where can I go from your spirit, oh God? Where can I flee from your presence? Jonah was asleep in the bottom of the ship, but God knew where to find him. Sin has a price, but repentance brings forgiveness. Sometimes it seems like one has to hit rock bottom before he or she will repent. When Jonah realized the storm was the result of his disobedience, he said, throw me overboard. Let us come to the point where we realize things are going wrong because of my disobedience to God. That's why things are not working out, because I am disobedient. So we must realize that when Jonah realized it's because of my disobedience, he said, just throw me overboard. He was looking at this as another way of escape. He didn't say, take me to Nineveh. I surely would have diverted the ship had he changed his mind and say, take me to Nineveh, because then God would have realized he had made up his mind to go. But Jonah said, throw me overboard. Some of us are looking for any avenue to get away from what God has called us to do, and we walk in disobedience. The men didn't readily want to throw him overboard. They struggled to get to land. They didn't want to throw him over because they knew what would happen if they threw him over. And so they struggled to get to land. The wind was boisterous. The storm was raging. The sea was rough. And this man is saying, throw me overboard. But they had a heart not to throw him overboard. They felt for him. And so they struggled to get to land. But when they saw how the sea was raging, they asked God for forgiveness and they threw Jonah overboard. Sometimes for your own peace of mind, you have to release the one that you are struggling, that you have been fighting for, and say, Lord, it's all in your hands. I have done my part and there's nothing more I can do. I release them unto you. You have your way. Don't stop believing God, though. Don't stop trusting him. Just stop struggling. Some of us spend so much time struggling to carry somebody in our family. Our only focus is on them. Our only focus is to pray for them. And sometimes our prayers are directed only for them, and we forget to pray for somebody else. We must reach the place where we say, God, is in your hands. I'm not struggling anymore. I release them. When God has a plan and a purpose, it must be fulfilled no matter what. God had prepared a big fish to swallow Jonah. Jonah cried out to God from the belly of the fish. He said, out of the belly of hell, I cried out to God. I cried out of the belly of hell. That's when Jonah realized that he had done wrong. Don't let us reach that place. Jonah repented, and all of Nineveh was spared because through Jonah, they received the message and repented. Who is depending on your message? Who is depending on your mission? Who is depending on your call to repent, for their lives to be spared? God chose you. Don't run. Has God spoken to you to go on a mission to save lives? Jesus expects us to spread the good news of the gospel to others, but some people run and try to hide like Jonah. Then when trouble comes, God gets the blame. Hear the voice of God speaking to you today, speaking to me, speaking to us. Will your answer be, yes, Lord? Will you say, yes, Lord, I will go where you send me? Or will you run away and hide? Say, yes, Lord, I will do what you have called me to do. In spite of how I may look, I will do what you have called me to do. You may be waiting on God, but God is waiting on you. God chose you. Don't run. Father, we thank you this morning for this word. Thank you for everyone that has received this word, Father. Everyone that you have chosen, everyone that you have called, everyone that you have sent. Because, Lord, there are some that go and you haven't sent them. But God, I thank you for your calling on those of us who are listening this morning. Help us to go, Lord God, and to do your will and your will alone. Not my will, God, but your will be done. Use us, Lord, for your honor and for your glory. In the mighty name of Jesus, we say, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, we will go where you send us to go. Cover JGRFM family this morning, God. Cover Sister Angela, her house, the radio station, Father. Lord God, we thank you and we praise you for every minister here on this JGRFM family. Lord God, we thank you for your anointing to do your will. We give you all the praise, all the glory, and all the honor. In Jesus' name, amen. God chose you. Don't run.